Did leaked IRS tax returns show George Soros wired $1.7 million to Antifa? No, that's not true. The Open Society Foundations, created by Soros, has made several large donations to the Center for Community Change, but that group is not affiliated with Antifa. The tax documents were not leaked since they are widely available public records. The claim originated in a Newspunch.com article in 2017 that was later retracted by the publisher. It was recently revived with social media posts pointing to an archived version of the retracted story, including in a post shared on June 7, 2020 under the title, "Check out for yourself who George Soros is funding." It opened, quote, "Leaked IRS tax returns shows that billionaire globalist George Soros sent over $1.7 million to Antifa, the domestic terrorist organization some say are responsible for the recent Las Vegas attack." End quote. This is what the post looked like on Facebook at the time of writing. Source: Facebook screenshot taken on Sunday, June 7, 19 hours 15 minutes and 23 seconds 2020 UTC. There is nothing connecting the Center for Community Change to Antifa. To better understand this, let's discuss what is Antifa. The Washington Post offered a good definition in a June 4, 2020 article titled "What is Antifa?" Quote, "Antifa is short for anti-fascists. It's pronounced N-T-F-U-H. Think of them as radical anti-racists who want to take matters into their own hands to try to stop white supremacy," said Mark Bray, a historian at Rutgers University and author of Antifa, the Anti-Fascist Handbook. "The difference between them and a normal opponent of these things is that anti-fascists don't trust government or police to efficiently bat down white supremacy and fascism. There's a suspicion among Antifa that police and a capitalist society are actually supportive of these ideals. So from there stems the notion of taking matters into their own hands, which lends an air of militancy to their mission." End quote. The Post story also tells us what Antifa is not. It is not a coherent group, quote. "Experts say the most common misconception is that the participants are a coherent group. Their numbers are small, though experts say the count is hard to pin down, and their organization is decentralized. In most U.S. cities, they are too small to have a visible presence. When making their most concerted effort to gather from across the nation, they've only reached a couple hundred. They spend most of their time not fighting or protesting, but rather tracking what neo-Nazis in their communities are doing and outing them to employees and neighbors." End quote. The Newspunch article tried to make a connection between Antifa and the mass shooting in Las Vegas that killed 58 people and left another 887 people injured in October 2017. There never was a credible allegation that Antifa was involved. The final investigation report concluded the attack was the work of a 64-year-old white man, Stephen Paddock. Read the New York Times article titled "Las Vegas Police Release Final Report on Massacre, with Still No Idea of Motive" for more on that. If you do not trust the Washington Post or the New York Times, then read what the Capital Research Center's Influence Watch project wrote on its Antifa page, quote, "Antifa's lack of centralized structure make it difficult to calculate the movement's size and membership. While interest has spiked since the 2016 presidential election, it remains virtually impossible to quantify how many people are active members or supporters of Antifa. The chapters of Antifa are loosely connected and highly secretive, and organize mostly on message boards such as Reddit and over social networks like Twitter and Facebook," end quote. In other words, it is not the Center for Community Change. The right-leaning Influence Watch, which tracks left-wing advocacy groups, confirmed that George Soros' Open Society Foundation has given financial support to that organization over several years. The Influence Watch page for the Center for Community Change includes this description of the group's activities, quote, "The Center for Community Change, CCC, is a left-of-center nonprofit that focuses on issues of poverty, race, housing policy, and the treatment of released prisoners. It also promotes the interests of immigrants, including illegal immigrants. Its affiliated 501(c)(4) Center for Community Change Action lobbies for progressive policies like the $15 per hour minimum wage proposed by the Service Employees International Union (SEIU), increasing taxes on the rich, and opposing the most affordable forms of energy. The center and its affiliates seek a large expansion of entitlement programs, including those related to welfare, healthcare, childcare, public housing, food stamps, and public transportation.